YouTube. I was reading the manual on that, and what it says to do is to charge and discharge. So I've done up something temporary, and I put my bigger inverter, and I just put it down here for now, because I don't have any longer cords, and I probably have to go out and buy something to make it a bit more permanent for doing this sort of stuff. Yeah, so I'm running extension cord out and into my bedroom. And what I've got running on it is a fan. So I just plugged it in. Put it there, and that's what the TV is using,
and that email,
the sound bar,
so whoever sent Katarina,
and the fan on high. And the brilliant thing about this particular inverter is that it has a charger built into it. So once I discharge it, I'm going to be plugging in on the AC and charging her up, because it's near the end of the day, and if I try and put at least one lot of the panels, I'm not going to really get anything, and it's not going to get fully charged. So yeah, I'm going to keep doing this until it gets a lot better. They said it could take up to 20 if it's really bad or something. So they said just charge it, discharge it, charge it, discharge it, and see if you got more of a performance out of it. So I'm going to give that a go and see how it goes. I decided to hook the whole battery bank together and just leave it going, because that was the other option. Yeah, and basically device is using 70 milliamps. It's just going to be take too long, and I have to run a cord in there just to try and get it to discharge and charge. So this is kind of the better option at the moment. Sun's down and I'm using 270 when I put the amp meter over it. When the sun goes down, I don't have much load on it. So that's a little bit of a update for you. It's been a couple of days. I had it one day with this hooked up all together, and the other day I did two discharge and charge. Just a little quick update. That's how much I'm bringing in on the second string. Well, really the main string, and that's how much I'm using. Just cool down the panels, clean them up a bit. Pretty much whatever I bring in, I pretty much use. I redid the wiring slightly. I found it was getting too warm, so I've cut off the quick connects and put that onto there. I'll wired it straight into there. Now that's a lot better. It's not getting hot anymore. Might have to run a little bit more load, and that might get more over 20, I guess. It's about the highest load I've ever had on this. I've seen it go up to 410. And it's a pretty hot day today. Not much of a cloud. Get my hose down and get them a bit of a clean. So at the moment I'm running fish lights, running pumps, playing my game. I've got the evaporative air con going. So as you can see, my batteries, with the tester, it says it's good. And with the battery extra, it seems to be doing the job. I've took all the batteries down yesterday and got them tested. So they all work good, apparently. Well, that one's a little bit lower with the resistance, but it's still a pass. I mean, that's the oldest battery there. So now I'm going to do it across. It basically comes up with what the last battery is. So that battery extra so far looks like it works. Yeah, so far definitely it works. Because I remember they weren't too good. So I guess time will see if they get any better or not. So I'll keep doing updates and see how it goes. Batteries are completely full. Don't have a massive load on it. It's a pretty warm day. Put a little bit of water on it to cool them down, and that'll give me more power, but I don't really need it, so I probably won't do it. There is more content to come, so like it, hate it, subscribe.
If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below. I'll catch you all on the next one. Thanks and bye.